Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to do the following problem. If the cosine of x is negative 3/5 and the sine of y is positive 12/13, with both x and y between 90 degrees and 180 degrees, find the following. So we're going to be using our different trig identities up through the double angle identities to answer the following, give the exact value. All right, let's start with the first one, the tangent of x minus y. So what's the formula for the tangent of x minus y? That's the tangent of x minus the tangent of y over 1 plus the tangent of x times the tangent of y. So I need to know the tangent of x and the tangent of y to do this problem. And in fact, in all of these problems, it would be nice to know the cosine, sine, and tangent. Now, both of these are in quadrant 2 because it says it's between 90 and 180 degrees. So let's just draw each angle. So x in quadrant 2, if we've got a negative 3/5, this would be negative 3, and this would be 5, and then you could use the Pythagorean theorem, or you might recognize this as the 3/4 triangle. That would be 4. So this is x. All right, now let's find y. The sine of y is 12/13. So that means the y value is 12. And r is 13, and that is my angle y. And hopefully you recognize this as the 5, 12, 13, but if not, you can use the Pythagorean theorem. So now by looking at the picture, I can tell what the tangent of x is, the tangent of y is, and just go ahead and plug them right into this formula. So the tangent of x, I look up here, y over x is 4 over negative 3, so I'm going to write that as negative 4/3. Minus the tangent of y. The tangent of y is 12 over negative 5. Remember to put the minus sign again, that's negative 12/5. I know it's really 12 over negative 5, but usually I write the minus sign in the numerator. So by the way, that's going to be a plus plus. Okay, we'll do that in a minute. And in the denominator, it's 1 plus the tangent of x times the tangent of y. So we're going to have negative 4/3 times negative 12/5. Okay, and then we have to simplify this complex fraction. Whoops, went a little too far. Sorry. Where are you? Okay, here we are. Okay, I'm going to first change that to a plus. All right, I'm going to change this to plus plus. And then I'm going to multiply by the least common denominator. So the least common denominator is 15. So I'm going to multiply the whole numerator by 15, whole denominator by 15 to get rid of this complex fraction. So I don't like working with complex fractions. So we have negative 4/3 times 15 plus 12/5 times 15. The denominator, 1 times 15 plus. And this is 48/15, right, times 15. So let's see what cancels. That'll be a 5. That'll be a 3. Nothing cancels here. Those are 1s. So that leaves me within the numerator. Be careful, there's still a minus sign here. Minus 4 times 5 is negative 20, plus 12 times 3 is 36 over 15. Plus 48. So my answer is what? 36 minus 20 is 16, and 15 plus 48 is 63. And that's the answer to the first thing we were asked. All right, so we were asked to find five things. Well, we've got our first answer, tangent of x minus y. Now let's go on to figuring out the sine of 2x. It's going to be helpful to have our pictures for x and y here because we'll be needing that information. So for this problem, we're looking for the sine of 2x, and the sine of 2x, the formula is 2 sine x cosine x. So all we need to know for this is the sine of x and the cosine of x. So we just need the first picture here. What's the sine of x? The sine is 4/5. And the cosine is negative 3/5. Nothing cancels. So say in the numerator, I have 2 times 4 times 3. That's 24, but it's negative. So it's negative 4, 24, 25ths. And we have the sine of 2x. So now we've done the second part. So for the sine of 2x, we could put negative 24 25ths. All right, we're ready to do the third part, cosine of x plus y. All right, we've got our trusty pictures again, and we're looking for the cosine of x plus y. So we need the formula for the cosine of x plus y, which is cosine x cosine y minus sine x sine y. So we just look over here and fill in the correct values. So first we have to look at the cosine of x. So look at the x. The cosine is negative 3/5. And then we need the cosine of y. So we look at this picture, negative 5/13. Minus, then we need the sine of x. So we're looking at this picture. That's 4/5. And we'll need the sine of y, which is 12/13. Now, it's true that you could cancel these 5s, but you know, I need a common denominator anyway, so I'm not going to cancel. So, you just multiply. We've got 15/65 minus 48/65, which is a negative number. I think that's 33. Negative 33/65. So now we've got the cosine of x plus y. So for the cosine of x plus y, we just did that problem and we got negative 33/65. All right, what's next? Cotangent of pi over 2 minus x. All right, now you should recognize this as one of the cofunctions. The cotangent of 90 degrees minus x is the same thing as the tangent of x. So that's the fast and easy way to do that. That's the same thing as the tangent of x. Now, if you forgot that, you could go ahead and rewrite that as 1 over the tangent of pi over 2 minus x. Use the formula, but it would take a lot longer. Much better to know that this is always true. And now we just look over here and say, what's the tangent of x? 4 over negative 3, which is negative 4/3. So that's our fourth part. Our answer is negative 4/3. So we have here negative 4/3, and we are on to our last part, cosine of negative x. Again, I really only need to look at my first picture here. But I'm just copying them both each time, just in case. All right, cosine of negative x. What we have to do is recognize that the cosine is an even function. So cosine of negative x is simply the same thing as the cosine of x. So all we do is look at the picture. The cosine is negative 3/5, and we're done. So these last two were pretty easy. You really have to know your formulas, though. You have to know your identities, and if you know them, you can just go directly. Otherwise, you could just be staring at it forever if you don't know how to get started because you don't even know your identities. So really important to know your trig identities. Okay, so there you have it. These are the answers to this problem. And if you forgot what the problem was, here it is. That was the problem. All right. So we've done it. Takes a little while, but we got through it. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.